C.H. Spurgeon on The Song of Solomon, Daily Meditations and Devotions, written by Charles Spurgeon, collection compiled by Christopher Glyn. Narrated by Christopher Glyn. Thy love is better than wine. Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 2. Nothing gives the believer so much joy as fellowship with Christ. He has enjoyment as others have in the common mercies of life. He can be glad both in God's gifts and God's works. But in all these separately, yea, and in all of them added together, he does not find such substantial delight as in the matchless person of his Lord Jesus. He has wine which no vineyard on earth ever yielded. He has bread which all the cornfields of Egypt could never bring forth. Where can such sweetness be found as we have tasted in communion with our beloved? In our esteem, the joys of earth are little better than husks for swine compared with Jesus, the heavenly manna. We would rather have one mouthful of Christ's love and a sip of his fellowship than a whole world full of carnal delights. What is the chaff to the wheat? What is the sparkling paste to the true diamond? What is a dream to the glorious reality? What is time's mirth in its best trim compared to our Lord Jesus in his most despised estate? If you know anything of the inner life, you will confess that our highest, purest, and most enduring joys must be the fruit of the tree of life which is in the midst of the paradise of God. No spring yields such sweet water as that well of God which was digged with the soldier's spear. All earthly bliss is of the earth, earthy, but the comforts of Christ's presence are, like himself, heavenly. We can review our communion with Jesus and find no regrets of emptiness therein. There are no dregs in this wine, no dead flies in this ointment. The joy of the Lord is solid and enduring. Vanity hath not looked upon it, but discretion and prudence testify that it abideth the test of years, and is in time and in eternity worthy to be called the only true delight. For nourishment, consolation, exhilaration, and refreshment, no wine can rival the love of Jesus. Let us drink to the full this evening. We will remember thy love more than wine. Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 4. Jesus will not let his people forget his love. If all the love they have enjoyed should be forgotten, he will visit them with fresh love. Do you forget my cross? Says he, I will cause you to remember it, for at my table I will manifest myself anew to you. Do you forget what I did for you in the council chamber of eternity? I will remind you of it, for you shall need a counselor, and shall find me ready at your call. Mothers do not let their children forget them. If the boy has gone to Australia and does not write home, his mother writes, has John forgotten his mother? Then there comes back a sweet epistle which proves that the gentle reminder was not in vain. So it is with Jesus. He says to us, remember me, and our response is, we will remember thy love. We will remember thy love and its matchless history. It is ancient as the glory which thou hadst with the Father before the world was. We remember, O Jesus, thine eternal love when thou didst become our surety and espouse us as thy betrothed. We remember the love which suggested the sacrifice of thyself, the love which, until the fullness of time, mused over that sacrifice, and longed for the hour whereof in the volume of the book it was written of thee, lo, I come. We remember thy love, O Jesus.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.